Okay, good morning, brothers and sisters. Welcome to ICS. Before we start our service, may I ask everyone please greet one another? Good morning. Yes, okay, you may be seated. Yeah, I hope you have a good stretch, especially a Sunday morning. And welcome to ICS. My name is Anderson, and it's wonderful for us to meet here at ICS Church to worship our God together. We are so glad you are able to join us here today. And just some procedural announcement. First of all, again, to remind every one of us about the foreign IDs, ICS is a multi-denominational Christian church, so in compliance with local government regulations, ICS service and events are open to foreign passports or foreign permanent residence holders only, and all participants are required to produce your foreign identification before you enter in our service, and we appreciate your collaborations and by showing your foreign IDs to our ushers. I use Mandarin to say again. ICS 是一个多宗派的一个教会，我们一起聚会。那我们遵守中国政府的规定。那我们进来的时候会邀请我们的弟兄姐妹，麻烦你们出示你们的身份证明。那这个也请各位感谢各位弟兄姐妹的配合。And if you have not yet known that on the third floor, which is one level above this, we also set up for parents with babies or elderly or some local parents if their children are joining us in Kids Church or Trailblazers. So we have the monitor and the sound system set up on the third floor. So if any of you or you know someone in need, you also can, or you have any questions, you can ask our ushers. And for whoever you drive to our church, you can get a hotel coupon for the parking, and it's a flat rate for RMB 15. And also, this hotel graciously offer our church members to have a restaurant meal discounts. So you can refer to the bulletin, or if you go have your lunch in the hotel, you can ask them and just let them know you are ICS members. You can enjoy the discount. And for lost and found, and if you left your any items or your belongings during the previous Sunday services, you may ask our ushers, and there is an information table, there is a lost and found box, and please go claim any items, and if anything not claimed before or not for over a month, it will be disposed. And for the ICS weekly bulletins, right now ushers outside will still give you the hard copy, but right now we also have the digital form, so you can scan the QR code, and we encourage you to do that, and it's a good practice. So you can see the digital bulletin for more church informations. Okay. And ICS is a cell church, if you didn't know. We encourage all our members to join our cell groups. We hope our brothers and sisters, you belong at least one cell group. So every week, we promote two cell groups. The first cell groups we are promoting is the ROC. It's a Chinese-speaking cell group. They are meeting right after the 9 a.m. service. And we also have another cell group, Breast Victory. It's an English-speaking cell group. So after the church service, you can go out and turn left. There is a cell group table. They would be there and share with you more our cell group information. And if you have not yet joined or belongs to any of the cell groups, we encourage you, please try. And our cell groups, we have many cell groups operating throughout the city of Shanghai and even in Pudong. So please talk to our brothers and sisters. We hope you also can get more church informations and also have our church members, our brothers and sisters journey with you while you are living or working in Shanghai. You won't feel alone. We are Christian family. So, 用中文说一次，就 ICS 是一个细胞小组的教会。如果您尚未属于任何一个细胞小组，我们欢迎您在聚会结束的时候，在外头我们有一个桌子，那里会有弟兄姐妹跟您分享我们教会细胞小组的讯息。那我们也在上海有很多的这个不同的地点都有细胞小组。那我们相信你必定会在这里面得到很大的帮助。那我们也会有这些爱主的弟兄姐妹跟您一起，那在这里学习成长，那在主内是一家人。 Okay, at this time, we also like to invite those who are attending our service for the first time. If you are new to Shanghai, this is your first time joining us, we would like to recognize you and say hi to you. We won't ask you to say anything, just raise your hand or stand at where you are. Anyone? Any newcomer? 有没有第一次参加我们教会聚会的弟兄姐妹？Anyone? Oh, not this week. Okay, so we need to do more work to get in touch and invite our friends. Okay, also as a tradition here at ICS, we like to recognize our members who have been worshiping with us for 6 months or even longer. If this is your last Sunday, you are moving out from Shanghai, moving away, let us know. We would like to have a short prayer with you. Anyone? 有没有人即将离开上海？这是你最后一次在这边跟我们一起聚会的，我们一起跟你祷告。Okay, no one is leaving. Okay, that's great. Okay, come, let's have a prayer before our praise and worship team lead us into God's presence. May I ask everyone please stand up? Let's have a short prayer. 弟兄姐妹，我们一起做一个祷告，那我们交给我们敬拜赞美的团队，带我们一起来赞美主。Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we give thanks to you, Lord. At this morning, our brothers and sisters, we are gathering together to worship you with our voice. And Lord, at this moment, Lord, please talk to every one of us and help us to cast out all our concerns, all our worries, no matter from work, from other areas, Lord. We believe, Lord, you care for us. And Lord, at this moment, we ask you, please strengthen us and help us to focus, to fix our eyes on you alone, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen, amen. Good morning, brothers and sisters in Christ. Hallelujah. Good morning. Welcome to the house of the Lord. Right? Welcome home. Hallelujah. Start to praise the Lord. Amen. Come on, let's do that.
Believe there is one salvation, one doorway that leads to life, one redemption, one confession. I believe in the name of Jesus Christ. I believe in the crucifixion, by his blood I have been set free.I believe in the resurrection. Hallelujah, this life is death's defeat.
Sing all praise.
All praise to God the Father. All praise to Christ the Son. All praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. The King who was sent is sent evermore. Jesus Christ. believe there is one salvation, one the way that leads to life, one redemption, one confession. I believe in the name of Jesus Christ. Let's do. I believe in the crucifixion. By His blood I have been set free. I believe in the resurrection. Hallelujah, His life is destined to be.
And all praise.
All praise to God the Father. All praise to Christ the Son. All praise to the Holy Spirit. A place for me, far beyond what hearts imagine, ears have heard or eyes have seen. I believe that the day is coming, He's returning to claim His bride. Like the altar, keep it burning, see the Lamb who roars the roaring lion.
All praise!
All praise to God the Christ the Son, all praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. The King who was and is and evermore will be. In Jesus' mighty name, I believe.
We'll sing the bridge now. Of the gospel of Jesus Christ. How could I ever walk away from the one who saved my life? No, I'll never be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. How could I ever walk away from the one who saved my life? No, I'll never be ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. How could I ever walk away from the one who saved my life?
Let's all give praise now.
All praise to God the Father. All praise to Christ the Son. All praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. The King who was sent is
again, church.
All praise to God our Father. All praise to Christ the Son. All praise to the Holy Spirit. Our God has overcome. The King who was and is and evermore will be. In Jesus' mighty name I believe.
In Jesus.
In Jesus' mighty name, I believe.
I believe, I believe. I believe in you, Lord. Come on, lift up praise to the Lord. Don't hold back, church. He's worthy, amen. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Praise the Father. Praise the Son. Praise the Holy Spirit, amen.
Sing together, Jesus.
Jesus.
His praise, oh, praise.
His name. Oh, praise His name. Let all His wondrous works declare His praise. Oh, praise His name. Oh, praise His name. Let all His wondrous works declare His praise. Oh, praise His name. Oh, praise His name. Let all His wondrous works declare His praise. Oh, praise His name. Oh, praise His name. Let all His wondrous works declare His praise.
See? It's your blood that gives me
me life. It's your blood that took my place in redeeming sacrifice. It washes me. God's precious sacrifice. Sing, my Jesus. My Jesus, God's precious sacrifice.
Father, we praise you. And we thank you that you have opened up a new and living way through the blood of Jesus Christ to enable us to come into your presence, to behold your face daily. We thank you for your love that you have towards us. We thank you that in this ever-changing environment, your love changes not for us. We thank you that you journey with us on a daily basis. And I pray that, Father, your wisdom will rest upon all of us in this changing environment. And I pray that, Father, even as you lead us and guide us, we will be obedient and to yield to you, Father God. We will deny our flesh, pick up the cross, and carry you on a daily basis. We thank you that, Father, we can continue to worship you with our tithes and our offering. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Please be seated. I'm going to teach a topical study this morning.
今天上午我想要有一个主题的教导。
It is regarding the power of the blood.
是关于宝血的大能。
It is a very, very important topic.
是一个非常非常重要的话题。
For several years, we have this guest speaker by the name of Dr. R.T. Kendall, who will come to preach to us on a yearly basis.
在过去好几年，我们都有Dr. R.T. Kendall 博士呢，来教导我们。
And he used to make this altar call every year.
他每年呢都会在讲台上面做个呼召。
It will go like this.
他会这么做。
If you were to stand before Jesus today,
如果你今天站在耶稣基督面前的
话 ，and he were to ask you a question, why would I let you come into my kingdom?
如果他问你，我为什么会让你进我的国度呢
？What would your answer be?
你的回答是什么呢？
And then he'll pause for a while.
然后他会暂停一下。
And he will give you the answer.
他就给你这个
答案。And he will also say.
然后他会说。
If that answer is other than what I've said, I don't want to be you.
如果那是我所说的话，我不想在你的这个位置上。
It is important for us to know why we are saved.
非常重要的是我们要知道我们为什么会得救。
How we are saved.
我们是如何得救的。
And whenever that altar call is being made.
不管怎么样，这个讲台的呼召是怎么做的。
And he will say, if some of you did not choose the answer that I have given you, I need you to stand.
如果你们今天的答案不是我今天要教导你们的，我想要你站起来。
It is very alarming to see the number of people standing.
那个时候，非常让大家警觉的是有多少人会站起来。
So I'm going to settle this answer once and for all today.
所以今天呢，我要为大家一次就解决这个问题。
I'm going to talk about the power of the blood.
今天我要讲的是宝血的大能。
You know, I talk about the full armor of God.
我跟大家讲过这个全套军装。
And the belt of truth.
这个真理的腰带。
And one of those foundational truths is the power of the blood that made atonement for our sin.
宝血的大能是他为我们赎了罪。
Salvation is a done deal that is offered to us purely by the grace of God.
救恩赐给我们完全是出于神的恩典。
But it cost the Heavenly Father dearly.
但是呢，他让天父付出了高昂的代价。
The second person of the Godhead must take our place on the cross.
三位一体神中的第二位呢，必须在十字架上代替我们。
Everything that we read in the Old Testament points towards the of the Messiah.
我们在旧约中读到的一切都指向那位弥赛亚。
And right now, I'd like to show you a diagram.
现在我想让大家看
一张图。We will also end off with this diagram.
我们看一下这张图。
Basically, I'm going to bring you from the Old Testament all the way to Revelation.
我将大家从旧约一直带到启示录。
Now, like I said, it is a topical study.
我说了今天这是一个主题的教导。
I will give you many passages.
我会给你很多段经文。
But it's on the theme of the power of the blood.
但是呢，是整个的贯穿这些经文的是一条血线。在今天的讲道中
I want you to understand that the Old Testament, everything that happened in the Old Testament always point towards the work of the cross.
在旧约中提到的一切都是指向十字架的救工。
And everything that we read in the New Testament, including our current Christian life, has to be referred back to the cross.
而我们就新约中提到的一切，包括我们今天基督徒的生活，都也是指向十字架。
It involves how we are to approach God.
这个讲到的是我们如何去接近神。
What makes us worthy before God?
什么能让我们站立在神的面前
？Let us look at why blood is needed for the atonement of our sins.
让我们看一下为什么在赎罪的时候需要宝血。
Leviticus chapter 17 verse 11 says.
利未记十七章十一节。
For the life of the flesh is in the blood.And I've given it to you upon the altar to make atonement for your souls. For it is the blood that makes atonement for the soul.
因为活物的生命是在血中，我把这血赐给你们，可以在坛上为你们的生命赎罪。因血里有生命，所以能赎罪。
So let me give you the definition of atonement.
所以让我给大家这个赎罪的这个定义。
The word atonement is derived from kuffa, which means ransom. So that kuffa means to atone by offering a substitute.To cover, to forgive, to make amends, to pardon, to appease, to expiate, extinguish the guilt of a crime by subsequent acts of piety or worship, by which the obligation to punish the crime is cancelled, to reconcile, to ransom, to remove by paying a price to be annulled. It is described a covering over, often with blood sacrifice, to atone for some sin. Atonement means that a price is paid.And blood is shed because life must be given for life.
赎罪源于 copa， 意思是赎金，所以呢，copa 的意思是通过提供替代品来赎罪，掩盖、原谅、弥补、赦免、安抚、赎罪，通过随后的虔诚或敬拜行为来消除罪行，惩罚罪行的义务由此取消，和解、赎金，以付出代价的方式除掉，使之废除。它描述了一种遮盖，通常用献祭的血来赎罪。赎罪意味着付出代价并流血，因为生命必须为生命而赎。扩展的定义是注解来的。
So I want you to remember this: that whenever sin is committed, there must be a substitutionary sacrifice, so that there will be a forgiveness of sin.
所以我想让大家记得这样的是：如果是有了罪行，一定要有一个替代的这个赎罪的行为。
So it is especially helpful to know the attributes of God to understand why God does certain things, especially when we are studying the atonement of the blood.
所以呢，我们要清晰地理解神的特性，才知道为什么有赎罪这件事。
God is good, holy, just, eternal, faithful, impartial, merciful, righteous, loving, wise, and many others to be named.
神是善良、圣洁、公正、永恒、信实、公平、仁慈、公义、慈爱、有智慧的，还有更多的品格。
Therefore, as humans.Fallen humans will never be able to fully comprehend the standard requirements of God when it comes to holiness, justice, mercy, and righteousness, especially towards sin.
因此，作为堕落的人类，我们永远无法完全理解神对圣洁、公正、怜悯和公义的标准要求。
We tend to be more relaxed, tolerant, and indifferent towards sin, especially when we are not saved or carnal in our ways as a believer.
我们倾向于对罪更加放松、宽容和漠不关心，尤其是当我们没有得救或者作为一个信徒，我们仍凭血气行义的时候。
God's holiness cannot allow nor tolerate sin unless the penalty of sin has been meted out.
神的圣洁不能允许、不能容忍罪，除非对罪的惩罚已经实施。
The wrath of God towards sin must be appeased.
神对罪的这个愤怒必须被平息。
The above scripture and many more scriptures in today's sermon reveal to us that sin cannot be atoned, can only be atoned by blood.
上面的经文和今天我们中的更多经文要我们揭示的是罪只能通过血来赎罪。
Therefore, you will see a bloodline throughout the Old Testament into the New Testament until the final atonement by the blood of Jesus Christ.
所以你将看到贯穿旧约到新约的这条血线，直到最后用耶稣基督的血来赎罪。
Nobody can use his personal works to attain God's love because atonement of sin must be paid by blood.
没有人可以凭自己来获得神的爱，因为罪必须用血来赎。
There is life in the blood.
在血里面有生命。
An innocent party must take the place of the sinner through the shedding of blood, regardless of whether it is an animal or the work of the Messiah.
无论是通过动物还是弥赛亚的救工，无辜的一方要必须通过流血来代替罪人。
Once we understand the extent of God has gone to establish peace with us, then it will help us to be secured in His love.Assured of our salvation and enter to a place of rest.
一旦我们明白神为了和我们和平付出了什么，将帮助我们在他的爱中得到安全感。
This is what I'm attempting to share with you today.
这就是今天我试图与大家分享的内容。
I will begin in the Garden of Eden.
我将从伊甸园开始。
Genesis 3:21 tells us, also for Adam and his wife, the Lord God made tunics of skin and clothed them.
创世纪三章二十一节，耶和华神为亚当和他的妻子用皮子做衣服给他们穿。
In the beginning, Adam and Eve never needed clothes because the glory of God was upon them.
在开始的时候，亚当夏娃根本就不需要衣服，因为神的荣耀就是他们的衣服。
They only needed clothes when they sinned against God.
他们得罪了神之后才需要衣
服。They realized that they were naked.
他们意识到他们是没有穿衣服
的。They begin to know what is good and evil.
他们开始知道什么是好，什么是邪恶。
An innocent animal was killed for God to make tunics of skin to clothe Adam and Eve after they have sinned against God.
在他们得罪神了之后，为了让他们穿上衣服，一个无辜的动物就被神杀死了。
Blood was shed when God killed the animal to clothe them.
这次第一次为神流了血，一个无辜的动物为他们的罪而死。
This was the first shedding of blood for sin when an innocent animal had to die for the sin of mankind.
这是第一次为罪流了血，一个无辜的动物呢，就为了人类的罪而死。
It was a token of God's love and grace to clothe them before they were asked to leave the Garden of Eden.
在他们被要求离开伊甸园之前，给他们穿上衣服呢，是神的爱和恩典的象征。
Therefore, you do realize that God first loved them before enforcing what was needed to be done to separate sinners from His presence.
所以你确实能意识到，神首先是爱他们，然后才去执行需要做的事。
It was also an education for Adam and Eve that an innocent party must shed blood to appease the wrath of God towards sin.
这也是对亚当和夏娃的一个教导，无辜的一方必须要流血来平息神对罪的愤怒。
Adam and Eve must have taught their children the way to approach God is through the sacrifice of an animal for their sin.
亚当和夏娃也一定教会了他们的孩子，接近神的方式呢，是通过献祭动物来赎罪。
So that's why in Genesis chapter 4 verse 3 to 5 says, In the process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought an offering of the fruit of the ground to the Lord. Abel also brought of the firstborn of his flock and of their fat. And the Lord respected Abel and his offering, but he did not respect Cain and his offering. And Cain was very angry and his countenance fell.
创世纪四章三到五节，有一日，盖隐拿地里的出产为供物献给耶和华，亚伯也将他羊群中投生的和羊的脂油献上。耶和华看中了亚伯和他的供物，只是看不中盖隐和他的供物，盖隐就大大的发怒，变了脸色。
Cain was very angry because he couldn't be accepted by God through his labor of love.
盖隐很生气，因为他不能通过他的爱的劳动被神接受。
Many till today are still attempting to be accepted by God based on their own strength.
直到今天，很多人仍旧试图基于我们自己的力量被神去接受。
We use philosophy and religion to attempt to be a good person.
我们用哲学和宗教来试图成为一个好人。
We want God to love us based on our own terms.
我们希望神按照我们的方式来爱我们。
Nobody is good.
没有人是完全
的好人。Because of the sin nature in man, so we will be evil in our thoughts and actions.
因为在人里面有罪的本性，所以我们的思想和行为都有恶在里面。
Our self-righteousness will cause us to be proud and defiant when we are provoked.
而我们的自义会导致骄傲，当被激怒的时候会目中无人。
Cain was a good example because he killed Abel in his anger when his offering was rejected by God.
盖隐就是个很好的例子，因为他的供物被神拒绝，他就愤怒地杀死了亚伯。
Have you ever wondered why God accepted Abel's offering and not Cain's offering?
你有没有想过，为什么神接受了亚伯的供物而不是盖隐的
？You might be thinking, but Cain spent so much time laboring in the field and brought the offering to God. Why did God reject his offering?
你可能会想，盖隐在地里辛勤的劳动，产出的物奉献给神，为什么神不接受呢
？God rejected his offering because he has already taught Adam and Eve that the only way to approach him has to be through the shedding of the blood of an animal.
神拒绝的原因是他已经教导了亚当和夏娃，接近他的唯一的方式就是要流一个供物的血。
Abel learned well.
亚伯是学得很好。
Abel understood that in order for me to approach God, I must learn from my parents that blood has to be shed by an animal.
亚伯从他的父母那儿学到了，要接近神的话，唯一的方式是要流动物的血。
So by faith, he approached God based on the teaching that was given to him.
所以凭着他接受的教导，他凭着信心来到了神的面前。
Without faith, it's impossible to please God.
没有人没有信就不能得神的喜悦。
Let me confirm it for you.
让我为大家再确认这一点。
Turn with me to Hebrews chapter 11, verse 4.
我们再看一下希伯来书十一章四节。
By faith, Abel offered to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained witness that he was righteous, God testifying of his gifts, and through it he being dead still speaks.
希伯来书十一章四节，亚伯因着信献祭于神，比该隐所献的更美，因此便得了称义的见证，就是神指他礼物做的见证。他虽然死了，却因着信仍旧说话。
Abel had faith that the shedding of the animal blood allowed him to have fellowship with God.
亚伯相信动物的血可以使他与神相交。
His faith in God's way of the sacrificial blood pleased God.
他因着信献祭于神，使神高兴。
Abel obtained his righteousness before God based on his faith in God's way through the need of the shedding of blood of an animal on behalf of himself.
亚伯在神面前称义，这基于他对神的方式的信心，就是需要为自己献上动物的血祭。
Praise the Lord that it is purely by the blood and not by works as attempted by Cain.
赞美主，这纯粹是靠着献上血祭，而不是像盖隐试图的那样靠他的行为。
This practice.Of sacrificing an innocent animal for the sin of people continued in Noah's time.
这种为了百姓的罪而献祭无辜动物的做法，在诺亚的时代仍在继续。
Remember, during Noah's time, the people became very wicked.
大家都记得，在诺亚的那个时代，人们变成的罪恶横行。
And God has to judge sin.
而神必须要审判罪。
God made Noah to build an ark.
然后神让诺亚。
Brought his whole family into the ark.
将他的整个家庭带入
方舟。Two by two, the animals went in.
然后动物也一对对上了方舟。
Can you imagine?
你能想象吗
？Being in the ark,
在方舟上的时候
，with your whole family,
跟你的全家在一起
，in an enclosed place,
在一个封闭的空间
，with all the animals,
和所有的动物在一起。
Who's going to clean their droppings?
谁能清理这些动物的这些？排泄物。
I'm sure there will be opportunity for Noah and his wife to quarrel.
我相信诺亚和他的妻子肯定有争吵。
I'm sure the siblings will say, "I did it last yesterday. You should be doing it now."
那些弟兄姐妹们肯定也在吵。我前天做了，今天该你做了。
So there might be a lot of unhappiness in the ark.
所以在方舟上可能有很多不开心的时刻。
So when the ark finally rested on the Mount of Ararat.
所以当最后方舟停在那个山顶上的时候
Notice what Noah did.
你有没有意识到诺亚做了什么
In Genesis 8:22 say, Then Noah built an altar to the Lord and took of every clean animal, of every clean bird, and offered burnt offering on the altar. And the Lord smelled a soothing aroma. Then the Lord said in his heart, I will never again curse the ground for man's sake. Although the imagination of man's heart is evil from his youth, nor will I again destroy every living thing as I have done.
创世纪八章二十到二十一节，诺亚为耶和华筑了一座坛，拿各类洁净的牲畜、飞鸟献在坛上为燔祭。耶和华闻着那馨香之气，就心里说：“我不再因人的缘故咒诅地，人从小时心里怀着恶念，也不再按着我才行的灭各种的活物了。”
It was a new beginning when Noah's family came out of the ark.
当诺亚的家从方舟出来的时候，是一个新的开端。
Noah understood the way to approach God and to appease God for sin is through the sacrifice of an innocent animal on behalf of themselves by the shedding of blood.
诺亚也明白，接近神、平息神对罪的愤怒的唯一的方法是为他们流血，献祭无辜的动物。
An animal had to take the place of the sinners.
而这个无辜的动物要代替这个罪人的位置。
Now let me reiterate this truth.
让我再把这个真理跟大家强调一下。
In order for God to be appeased because of the sin of man, a substitutionary sacrifice has to be made.
为了平息神对罪的愤怒，一个无辜的人必须要代替这个罪人来赎罪。
There must be shedding of blood.
是必须要流血的。
It cannot be done through good works.
不能通过各种善行来成就。
If it can be done through good works,
它可以通过善行来成就。
If it can be done through good works,
如果这样可行的话
，Jesus would have died in vain.
耶稣的就白白死了。
If you are trying to use your own strength to appease God,
如果你想要试图用自己的努力来让神喜悦，
you will fail miserably.
你肯定会悲惨的失败的。
Amen.
Amen.
So that's why for many religion that teach man to be good.
所以有很多宗教都教导人要行善。
These people will fail miserably.
这些人最终都是悲惨的失败。
Many religion is about doing.
很多的宗教都是关于要做。
Christianity is the done deal.
而基督教是说你已经成了。
It is finished.
已经成就了。
We're going to get there.
我们接下来就会讲到那里。
So you better have the right answer when you go to heaven.
所以你去到天堂的时候最好有正确的答案。
My responsibility is finished after this sermon.
今天我的教导结束以后我的职责就完成了。
So God chose the Jews to bring the Messiah through the unconditional covenant with Abraham.
所以呢，神就选择了以色列人来成就他跟亚伯拉罕立的无条件的约。
Everything that we read in the Old Testament points towards the work of the Messiah on the cross.
所有我们在旧约中读到的都是指向弥赛亚。
So it begins with the unconditional covenant of Abraham to send for the Messiah in a just, righteous way.
所以呢，他开始与亚伯拉罕无条件的盟约，要用公正和正义的方式派出弥赛亚。
God had to test his covenant partner Abraham to offer up Isaac, his only son of promise.
而神又考验他的盟约伙伴亚伯拉罕，把他唯一的应许之子以撒献上。
Let's have a look at Genesis chapter 22, verse 13 to 14.
让我们看一下创世纪二十二章十三到十四节。
Then Abraham lifted his eyes and looked, and there behind him was a ram caught in a thicket by its horn.So Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up for a burnt offering instead of his son. And Abraham called the name of the place, The Lord will provide. And it's said to this day, In the mouth of the Lord it shall be provided.
亚伯拉罕举目观看，不料有一只公羊两脚扣在稠密的小树中。亚伯拉罕就取了那只公羊来献为燔祭，代替他的儿子。亚伯拉罕给那地方起名叫耶和华以勒，直到今日人还说，在耶和华的山上必有预备。
Abraham passed the test.
亚伯拉罕通过了试炼。
He was willing to offer up Isaac, believing that God can raise him up.
他愿意献上以撒，相信神能使他复活。
God stopped him in the nick of time and provided a ram as the burnt offering instead of Isaac.
神在最后关键的时刻拦住他，用一只公羊代替以撒做燔祭。
The doctrine of the blood is foreshadowed again.
血的这个信条呢，又一次埋下了伏笔。
The great lesson of substitution is clearly taught when the ram was provided to take the place of Isaac.
当这个公羊被提供来代替以撒的时候呢，就是关于这个替代的清晰的教导。
Abraham's act of offering on Mount Moriah paved the way for the final offering on Calvary.
亚伯拉罕在摩利亚山上的献祭，为加勒山上的最后的献祭铺平了道路。
Jesus was our substitution on the cross.
耶稣在十字架上就是我们的替代者。
This reiterated blood must be shed for the atonement of sin and the redemption of mankind.
这再一次强调了为赎罪和救赎人类必须要流血。
God is impartial, though He chose the Jews, but all the nations of the earth will be blessed.Through the unconditional covenant with Abraham.
神是公正的，虽然他选择了犹太人，但地上所有的民族都通过与亚伯拉罕无条件的盟约而受到祝福。
So are you following me through the timeline?
所以大家有没有跟着我明白了这个时间线？
So after Abraham came a time when the of course the story continued until the Israelites were in slavery over in Egypt.
所以在亚伯拉罕之后呢，这个时间进一步向前延展，直到那个以色列人在埃及成了奴隶。
Those people at the time didn't know God.
那些人并不了解神。
They don't even know His attributes.
他们都不了解神的
品格。So God had to teach them how to approach God.
所以神要教导他们如何接近他。
So during this time, God raised up Moses.
所以在那个时候，神就兴起了摩西。
Moses came before the Pharaoh.
而摩西来到法老面前
，asked for the release of his people，
想要法老来释放他的
民族。The heart of Pharaoh was hardened，
而法老的心被硬了。
And all the plagues began to take place，
所以在埃及地降下了很多灾。
And it came upon a time，
然后到某一个时刻
，when God was about to send the angels across Egypt，
神就派了天使行遍埃及全地。
All the firstborn will be dead，
所有的头生子都死了。
But God was gracious to the Israelites because of His covenant relationship。
但是神因为他的盟约关系对以色列人特别施了恩典。
Again, you will see blood has to be shed.
再一次你又看到必须要流血。
So how to separate the Israelites from the Egyptians?
所以怎么把以色列人和埃及人区分开来呢？
It is the application of blood on the doorposts and the lintels.
它是在它的门沿上和门边上要涂上血。
So we come to a place of the Passover.
所以就有来到了逾越节。
The Passover is pertaining to the Jews only; has nothing to do with the Christians.
逾越节是跟犹太人相关的，跟基督教还不相关。
Is Exodus chapter 12 verse 13 says.Now the blood shall be a sign for you on the houses where you are, and when I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be on you to destroy you when I strike the land of Egypt.
出埃及记十二章十三节，这血要在你们所住的房屋上做记号。我一见这血就越过你们去。我击杀埃及地头生的时候，灾殃必不临到你们身上灭你们。
God had to allow the firstborn of the Egyptian to die as Pharaoh hardened his heart against releasing the people of Israel.
因为法老硬了心，不让以色列民离开，神不得不击杀埃及地的头生子。
So it is a show to us how God differentiated in dealing with the Israelites and the rest of the world.
这显示了神是如何区别对待以色列人和其他人的。
The way to differentiate the Israelites and the Egyptians' household is through the application of blood on the doorpost and the lintel.
区分以色列人和埃及人的方法是在他们住的房子的门柱上涂上鲜血。
Every Israelite household must apply the blood of the Paschal Lamb.
每个以色列的家要涂抹逾越节羔羊的血。
An unblemished lamb must take the place of the firstborn in the Israeli family.
在以色列的家中，一只没有瑕疵的羔羊将取代他长子的位置。
The angel will pass over those households where the blood of the Paschal lamb was applied on the doorpost.
天使们会越过那些在门柱上涂有逾越节羔羊血的那些家。
The word said, "When I see the blood, I will pass over you." Was a lesson for the people that life.Can be obtained only by the death of a substitute.
我一见这血就越过你们去。这句话呢，给人们上了一课：只有替代者的死才能赎得生命。
So every year they celebrate Passover.
所以他们每年都庆祝逾越节。
To remember the mercy of God over their family.
记得神对他们的恩慈。
And God continued to teach His people after the law was given as the foundation of the Mosaic covenant.
在律法成为摩西盟约的基础之后，神继续教导他的子民。
The difference in Egypt was the blood was applied on the doorpost, whereas in Sinai, the blood was sprinkled on the people themselves.
不同之处在于，在埃及的时候呢，血被涂在门柱上，而在西奈山呢，血就洒在人的身上。
Exodus 24:5-8 says, Then he sent young men of the children of Israel who offer up burnt offerings and sacrifice peace offering of oxen to the Lord. And Moses took half the blood and put it in basins, and half the blood he sprinkledOn the altar. Then he took the book of the covenant and read it in the hearing of the people, and they said, All that the Lord has said, we will do and be obedient. And Moses took the blood, sprinkled it on the people, and said, This is the blood of the covenant which the Lord has made with you according to all these words.
出埃及记24:5-8，又打发以色列人中的少年人去掀翻祭，又向耶和华献牛为平安祭。摩西将血一半沉在盆中，一半撒在坛上，又将约书念给百姓听。他们说：“耶和华所吩咐的，我们都必遵行。”摩西将血撒在百姓身上，说：“你看，这是立约的血，是耶和华按这一切话与你们立约的凭据。”
It teaches without blood there could be no access by sinful man to a holy God.
这个教导的是没有血，有罪的人就无法接近圣洁的神。
Thereafter, you will read that God gave them instruction to build a sanctuary for Him, so that He could dwell among them.
在这之后呢，神指示他们为他建造一个会幕，这样他可以住在他们中间。
That's the tabernacle where God gave them detailed instruction to build it.
这就是会幕，神给了他们详细的建造指示。
It is a blessing of having their covenant God dwell among them.
与他们立约的神跟他们同住在一起，这绝对是祝福。
Through His grace, they might find Him and serve Him in this house.
而借着他的恩典，他们可以找到他，在他的殿里面侍奉他。
So the way to approach God was instituted.
所以接近神的方法被设立了。
There must be an offering of the individual, and there must also be an offering for the nation.
也需要为人献祭，也需要为这个民族和国献祭。
Leviticus chapter 1 verse 1-4 says.
利未记一章一到四节。
Now the Lord called to Moses and spoke to him from the tabernacle of meeting, saying, "Speak to the children of Israel and say to them, When any one of you bring an offering to the Lord, you shall bring an offering to the livestock of the herd and of the flock. If his offering is a burnt offering of the herd, let him offer a male without blemish. He shall offer it on his own free will at the door of the tabernacle of the meeting before the Lord. Then he shall put his hand." on the head of the burnt offering, and it should be accepted on his behalf to make atonement for him.
耶和华从会幕中呼叫摩西，对他说：“你晓谕以色列人说，你们中间若有人献供物给耶和华，要从牛群、羊群中献牲畜为供物。他的供物若以牛为燔祭，就要在会幕门口献一只没有残疾的公牛，可以在耶和华面前蒙悦纳。他要按手在燔祭牲的头上，燔祭便蒙悦纳，为他赎罪。”
Now at this juncture, I want you to know that the Israelites would have received the commandments.
在这个时点，我想让大家知道，以色列人已经收到了从神这边给他的诫命。
The commandment is a schoolmaster to teach the people of Israel what sin is.
这些诫命就像校长一样，告诉以色列人什么是罪。
And in the book of Leviticus, they also taught how to approach God ceremonially through the sacrifice of an animal.
而在立位记中呢，又教导了以色列人如何通过献祭的这个形式来接近神。
It is a very difficult process for them to be able to approach God.
对他们来说是一个非常艰难的这个流程来接近神。
The sin nature in them will cause them to sin habitually.
他们的罪的本性已导致他们以时常的犯罪。
The interesting thing about the book of Leviticus is it speaks about the coming work of Christ.
立位记的有趣之处在于它讲述了基督即将完成的工
作。It is a foreshadow of what will be done for us by Jesus Christ.
这也预表着耶稣基督将为我们做什么。
Firstly, the sacrifice at the altar speaks of the work of Christ.
首先祭坛上的献祭呢说明了基督的工作。
Secondly, the duty of the priest also speaks of the work of Christ. It will help us to understand what is written in the book of Hebrews regarding what Jesus does for us in the heavenly tabernacle after his resurrection.
其次祭司的职责也谈到了基督的工作这帮助我们理解在希伯来书中说到的关于耶稣复活以后在天上的会幕中为我们在做什么
You will be able to draw a parallel from the book of Hebrews regarding what was happening in the book of Leviticus
你可以做一个对比就是希伯来书中提到的和立位记中提到的信息
So in order for you to understand the book of Hebrews you must understand the book of Leviticus
所以为了理解希伯来书你先要理解立位记
In the book of Leviticus it reveals to us the way to approach God is through offering the offering of blood
立位记向我们揭示了接近神的方式就是献祭
The tabernacle of meeting is the place God's presence dwelt until the temple was built by Solomon
会幕是神的居所，直到所罗门建立了圣殿。
The pillar of cloud over the tabernacle represented the presence of God.
帐幕上的云柱代表了神的同在。
It is the glory of God.
它是神的荣耀。
This is the first time the presence of God was with the people of Israel.
这是神第一次与以色列民同在。
The way to approach and worship God is through the offering of an unblemished lamb.
而接近和敬拜神的方式是通过献一个没有瑕疵的羔羊。
It is a spiritual and physical cleansing before worshiping a holy God.
在敬拜神圣的神之前呢，他要进行属灵和身体上的洁净。
The priest will represent the people before God.
祭司在神面前代表的是百姓。
The tabernacle is a continuous emphasis that there is no forgiveness of sin without the shedding of blood for the individual and the nation.
而帐幕呢，在不断的强调，如果不为个人和这个民族流血的话，罪就不能宽恕。
The blood makes atonement for the individual and the nation.
血是为个人和民族赎罪的。
Let me tell you why is this topic so important.
让我告诉大家为什么这个话题这么重要。
Firstly, it teaches us that it is Jesus' blood that purchased our redemption.
首先，它教导我们是耶稣基督的宝血赎了我们。
It revealed to us the mercy and the love of God.
向我们揭示了神的恩慈和怜悯。
Despite of our sinfulness.
不管我们的罪，无论我们的罪的本性如何。
When a Christian fully understands this truth.
当一个基督徒完全理解这个真理之后
Regarding the mercy and the love of God,
关于神的爱和怜悯
We will also be merciful and gracious to the people around us.
我们也会对身边的人有恩慈有怜悯
Are you gracious and merciful to the people around you?
你有没有对你身边的人有恩慈有怜悯呢
if God has forgiven youCan you also forgive other people?
如果神已经宽恕了你，你能宽恕别人吗？
So let me give you the definition of atonement again.
所以让我给大家再一次讲一下赎罪的
定义。In the middle of this message,
在我们这个讲道的中间。
The definition of atonement, please bear this in mind.
请大家记住这个赎罪的定义。
The word is kafar. It's derived from kofar, which means ransom. So that kafar means to atone by offering a substitute. To cover, to forgive, to make amends, to pardon, to appease, to expiate. Extinguish the guilt of a crime by subsequent acts of piety or worship by which the obligation to punish the crime is cancelled. To reconcile, to ransom, to remove by paying a price, to be annulled. It describes a covering over. Remember this. It describes a covering over, often with blood of sacrifice, to atone for some sin. Atonement means that a price is paid. Blood is shed because life must be given for life.
赎罪这个词呢，源于 copa， 它的意思是赎金，所以 copa 的意思是通过提供替代品来赎罪，掩盖、原谅、弥补、赦免、安抚、赎罪，和解、赎金这些都是它的定义。用付出代价的方式来除掉，使之废除。它描述了一种遮盖，通常用献祭的血来赎罪。赎罪呢，意味着付出代价并流血，因为生命必须为生命而赎。So
we have come to a place where God taught them to establish the tabernacle of sacrifice.
所以呢，在这里神就让他们建立了这个会幕。
If we look at the tabernacle, we have no time to go into detail of it.
我们看一下这个会幕。
There is the court.
有院子。
Where the sacrifice is being made.
在这里呢，就进行了献祭。
The altar of burnt offering.
有献燔祭的坛。
And then over here, this is the holy place.
然后我们有圣所。
And then you see the veil.
然后有一个幔子。
The veil is about 1.5 feet thick.
这个幔子是非常厚的， 1.5英尺的厚。
It is not like the size of your curtain at home.
它不是像家里的这个帘子这样。
It is not of the same thickness as your home curtain.
它是非常厚的。
Some scholars believe that it's about 1.5 feet thick.
有的学者认为它有1.5英尺厚。
Even if two horses were to be tied to the extreme end, you will never be able to tie from the top of the bottom to the bottom.
要无论花多大的力气，你也不可能把它从中间撕开。
But can you remember on the day when Jesus gave up His Spirit?
但你还记得当耶稣在十字架上？
The veil was torn from the top to the bottom.
那个幔子就从上到下就裂开了。为什么呢？
Why?
为什么呢？
You have to know the reason.
你要知道这个原因。Now
this diagram give credit to Professor Daniel Sheets of Olivet Nazarene University. The atonement for the forgiveness of sin is through the blood.
那赎罪是通过血来实现的。
There is a sacrifice for the individual and for the nation.
这是为个人和民族的献祭。
The dying of the innocent for the guilty.
无辜者为罪者而死。
There are the trespass and sin offering for the individuals that's offered up willingly.
个人自愿地献上这个赎罪祭。
It must be the offering of a lamb without blemish.
它必须是一只没有瑕疵的羔羊。
You can imagine that there will be continuous sprinkling of blood without ceasing from morning till evening.
你可以想象，从早到晚会不断的有血在那撒。
That means every individual who come willingly must come with an unblemished lamb.
意味着每个去献赎罪祭的人都要带一只没有瑕疵的羔羊。
And the priest will be very busy from morning until evening every day.
而祭司呢，从早到晚非常的忙碌，每一天都这样。
So that there is the offering of the individual.
所以呢，这是为个人的献祭。
And then there's an offering for the nation.
然后有为民族和国家的献祭。
On the day of Yom Kippur.
在这个赎罪日的时候。
Yom Kippur is the day where sacrifice is made for the nation of Israel. Yom Kippur is called the Day of Atonement.
赎罪日是为以色列国献祭的日子，它就被称为赎罪日。It's
found in Leviticus chapter 23, verse 27, it says.
利未记23章26到27节。
And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, Also the 10th day of this 7th month shall be the day of atonement. It shall be a holy convocation for you. You shall afflict your souls and offer an offering made by fire to the Lord.
7月初十是赎罪日，你们要守为圣会，并要刻骨己心，也要将火祭献给耶和华。
Yom Kippur sacrifice is the most solemn of the year.
赎罪日的献祭是年中最庄严的日子。
It is making atonement for all the sin of the people of Israel once a year.
这是为以色列人的一切的罪一年一次的献祭。
You might ask, you know, what if all those Israeli who were not able to afford a lamb, an unblemished lamb, only rich people could afford to bring a lamb?
你可能会问，如果那些人很穷，没有办法负担一个没有瑕疵的羔羊的话，怎么办
？So Yom Kippur is the day where the whole nation of Israel will be forgiven.
所以赎罪日就是这一天，所有的以色列民都会被饶恕。
That's the time once a year when a high priest will enter the Holy of Holies to sprinkle the blood at the golden throne.
每年的这个时候，大祭司就进入至圣所，在这个金色的这个宝座上洒血。
Now,You will understand when you read the book of Hebrews. Once you understand this process,
你理解了这个过程的话，就能理解希伯来书了。
Because Jesus took His blood to the heavenly tabernacle to offer it up for the forgiveness of our sins.
因为耶稣基督去到天上的会幕，用他的宝血来为我们赎罪。
Before the high priest entered the holy of holies, he must purify himself.
在大祭司进去之前，他必须要洁净自己。
The water must have the ashes of the sacrifice of a heifer. The high priest entered to sprinkle the blood and to worship God.
这个水里呢要有献祭的牛犊的灰，然后大祭司进去洒血敬拜神。
So in Hebrews chapter 9 verse 7.
所以在希伯来书九章七节。
But in the second part, the high priest went alone once a year, not without blood, which he offered from himself and for the people's sin committed in ignorance.
至于第二层帐幕，唯有大祭司一年一次独自进去，没有不带着血为自己和百姓的过错献上。
It's no fun to be a high priest in the Old Testament.
在旧约里面做大祭司并不是一件有趣的事情。
And once a year,
每年一次
，you will wonder. You must ensure that the sacrifice is done correctly.
你要确保这个献祭的过程是正确的进行的。
If not, he will die in the Holy of Holies.
如果没有正确的做的话，他可能就在至圣所里死了。
You know, sometimes all of us take it for granted as Christians that we can enter into the presence of God with boldness without fear.
你知道，作为基督徒，我们有时候想当然的认为我们可以进入神的面前，不用惧怕。
In the Old Testament, I think the high priest would be in fear and trembling.
而在旧约里面，这个大祭司是惧怕的发抖。
So there is a process for him to prepare himself before he enters into the Holy of Holies, into the holy presence of God.
在进入至圣所，来到圣洁的神面前的时候，有一个很长的流程，他要遵守。
Can you imagine when the people were carrying the ark, when they tried to stable the ark, they died?
你还记得人们抬这个约柜的时候，因为不小心触碰了它，要扶稳它，结果就死了。
So let me share with you what is written in regarding the work of the high priest on the Day of Atonement from manners and custom that was written in 1875.
让我跟大家分享一个写在1875年的时候关于礼仪和风俗的书上怎么说的。
Let's go more in depth into what he did. Okay, on this day, the high priest clad in plain white linen garments brought for himself a young bullock.For sin offering and a ram for burnt offering. And for the people, two young goats for sin offering and a ram for burnt offering. The two goats were brought before the door at the tabernacle, and by the casting of lots, one was designated for sacrifice and the other for scapegoat. The high priest then slaughtered the bullock and made a sin offering for himself and family. He next entered the most holy place for the first time, bearing a censer with burning coals, with which he filled the place with incense.Taking the blood of the slain bullock, he entered the most holy place the second time, where they sprinkled the blood before the mercy seat. He next killed the goat, which was for the people's sin offering, and entering the most holy place for the third time, sprinkled his blood as he had sprinkled that of the bullock. Some of the blood of the two animals was then put on the horns of the altar of incense and sprinkled it on the altar itself. After this, the high priest, putting his hand on the head of the scapegoat,Confess the sin of the people and then send him off into the wilderness. Then he washed himself and changed his garment, arraying himself in a beautiful robe of his high priest, and offered the two rams as burnt offering for himself and for the people.
在赎罪日，大祭司的工作包括：当这日大祭司穿细麻衣，牵一只公牛犊为赎罪祭，牵一只公绵羊为燔祭，又为百姓献两只公山羊为赎罪祭，一只公绵羊为燔祭。把两只公山羊牵到会幕门口沾烟，选定一个祭物，一个做替罪羊。大祭司宰了公牛，为自己和家人献上赎罪祭。他头一次进入了圣所，拿着烧炭的香炉，把香充满了圣所。他第二次带着被杀公牛的血进入圣所，把血洒在施恩座前，又杀了那只做赎罪祭的山羊。第三次进入了圣所，像洒公牛的血一样洒了他的血，又把这两只动物的血抹在香坛的四角上，又洒在坛上。这事以后，大祭司把手按在替罪羊的头上，承认百姓的罪，就打发他往旷野去。他就洗了身，换了衣服，穿上华美的袍子，为自己和民众献上两只公羊为燔祭。
In the Old Testament,
这是旧约。
The high priest represents the people.
大祭司是代表着他的民众。
In the New Testament,
而在新约中
，When you remember in the book of Hebrews, Jesus represents you and I.
希伯来书中提到，耶稣代表了我们。
In the Old Testament,
在旧约中
，The individual offering is being done every day.
为个人的赎罪祭是每天都在做的。
The priest is busy from day to night.
祭司从早到晚非常忙碌。
And then once a year,
而一年一次。
The high priest enters into the holy of holies.
大祭司进入至圣所。
Three times.
三次。
On the third time,
直到第三次的时候。
When he comes out,
当他出来的时候。
The whole of Israel rejoices.
整个以色列民都欢欣鼓舞。
Why? Because they know that God has received their offerings.
因为他们知道神已经接受了他们的献祭。
And they are forgiven of their sin.
他们的罪被赦了。
For the time being only.
而只是 为那一年。
Because if you read,
如果你读这个经文的话。
David said in Psalms 103 verse 12.
在诗篇103章12节
As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us.
东离西有多远，他叫我们的过犯离我们也有多远。
There is a reminder of their sin every year.
这也是对他们的罪的每年的提醒。
And animals can never take away the sin of mankind.
动物的血永远没办法把人的罪完全带走。
You know, this was done continuously for 1500 years.
这个献祭一直进行了有1500年。
It was done on Mount Sinai.
它是在西奈山上做的。
In the desert.
在旷野里。
At Shiloh in the temple of Mount Moriah.
在示罗在摩利亚山上的殿中。
It continued until the Lord made an end of all the types and shadow of the Old Testament.
直到耶和华神终止了旧约的各种的礼仪。
Remember, I told you that the Old Testament is a type and shadow will point towards the coming of the Messiah.
我前面提到旧约中提到的各种献祭都是指向弥赛亚。
Remember when Jesus said, you know, offerings and sin offering you did not desire, but a body you have prepared for me?
耶稣曾经提到过，你并不想要这些献祭。
So look at what John the Baptist said.
所以约翰说了什么呢
John 1:29 The next day John saw Jesus coming towards him and said Behold the Lamb that takes away the sin of the world
约翰福音章29节次日约翰看见耶稣来到他那里就说看哪神的羔羊除去世人罪孽的
We have covered in the earlier part of this sermon that an innocent party has to take the place of sinner and blood must be shed
我们在这篇讲到之前已经讲过，无罪的一方要代替罪人，必须流血。
God has taught His chosen people how to approach Him through the sacrificial system in the book of Leviticus.
在利未记中，神教导了他的选民如何通过献祭来亲近他。
When blood is shed, then it covers the sin of the individual and the nation.
血流出的时候，遮盖了人和国家的罪。
There is a yearly reminder of their sin because the blood of animals cannot completely take away their sins.
每年要提醒他们这个罪，因为动物的血不能完全除去他们的罪。
Therefore, God prepared a body through His only Son, Jesus Christ, and the shedding of His blood to take away the sin of the world once and for all.
所以神借着他独生子耶稣基督所流的血，预备了个身体来一劳永逸。赞美神。
The work of Jesus and His blood is different.
耶稣的工作和他的宝血是不同的。
So let's go into the book of Hebrews.
让我们看一下希伯来书。
Hebrews chapter 10 verse 5 and 10 says, Therefore he came into the world, he said, Sacrifice and offering you did not desire. Remember, he's talking about Leviticus, right? But a body you have prepared for me. In burnt offering and sacrifice for sin you have no pleasure. Then I said, Behold, I have come in the volume of the book that's written of me to do your will of God.Previously saying, sacrifice and offering, burnt offering and offering for sin you did not desire, nor had pleasure in them which are offered according to the law. Then he said, Behold, I've come to do your will, O God. He takes away the first established by Moses, that he may establish the second which is done by Jesus. By that will we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once and for all.
希伯来书十章五到十节，所以基督到世上来的时候就说，神啊。祭物和礼物是你不愿意的你曾给我预备了身体燔祭和赎罪祭是你不喜欢的那时我说神啊我来了为要照你的旨意行我的事在经卷上已经记载了以上说祭物和礼物燔祭和赎罪祭是你不愿意的也是你不喜欢的这都是按照律法献的后又说我来了为要照你的旨意行可见他是除去在先的为要立定在后的我们凭这旨意 靠耶稣基督只一次献上他的身体就得以成圣。
There must be an innocent and unblemished animal who had to take the place of the sinner.
必须要有无辜无瑕疵的动物来代替罪人。
While the blood of the unblemished animal was able to appease God's wrath temporarily, but it wasn't something that he desired nor gave him pleasure.
虽然没有瑕疵的动物的血能够暂时平息神的愤怒，但这并不是他所希望的，也不是他喜欢的。
Nobody except the high priest was able to enter the holy of holies in the Old Testament tabernacle and temple sacrifices.
除了大祭司之外，没有人能进入旧约的帐幕和圣殿来献祭的圣至圣所。
God had a better and more perfect plan.
神有一个更好、更完美的计划。
It is through the body and blood of Jesus Christ.
就是通过耶稣基督的身体和宝血。
Do you remember that God had intentionally established an unconditional covenant with Abraham so that he can justly, righteously send forth the Messiah to redeem mankind from their sins?
神有意与亚伯拉罕立下无条件的约，这样他就可以公正、公义的派遣以赛亚来救赎。
It took time for Jesus to come. Therefore, the tabernacle and temple sacrifices were just a temporary solution for his people.
耶稣的到来需要一段时间，会幕和圣殿的献祭对他的子民来说只是个暂时的解决方案。
There must always be the shedding of blood before the sinners are able to approach to worship God.
在任何罪人接近敬拜神之前，要有流血的过程。
You should be able to remember that there was the high priest who ministered on behalf of the people of God.
你应该记得有一位大祭司在代表以色列人服事。
Now remember the Passover.
大家记得逾越节。
Right, there must be a lamb.
必须有一个
an unblemished lamb.
无瑕疵的羔羊。
Right, and when Jesus was questioned by Pontius Pilate.
而当耶稣被那个
比拉多
被比拉多质询的时候
，Pontius Pilate found him sinless.
比拉多认定他是无罪的。
There's no fault.
他根本就没有犯任何的
错。He wanted to release Jesus.
他想要释放耶稣。
When he was being questioned,
当他被质询的时候
，at the same time,
在同一
at the temple,
在那个圣殿里
，lambs were being brought forth.
那些羔羊都被赶到圣殿那边，
Inspected.
被检查过。
At the same time.
而在同一个时间
，Remember，
要记得
，Jesus is the Lamb of God，
耶稣就是神的羔羊
，that takes away the sin of the world，
他带走这个世上的罪
，He came to take away the first to establish the second，
他进入了他首先进来要除去过去的带来新的
，Amen， and that's why we read in Hebrews chapter 10 verse 11 to 12。
这是为什么我们读到的希伯来书中的。
Look at this scripture. It says, "And every priest then ministering daily and offering repeatedly the same sacrifice, which can never take away sin, but this man, after he had offered one sacrifice for sin forever, sat down at the right hand of God. This is the covenant I will make with them after those days," says the Lord. "I will put their laws in their heart and in their mind, and I'll write them." Then he adds, "Their sin and lawless deeds I will remember no more."Now, where there is remission of these, there is no longer an offering for sin.
凡祭司天天站着侍奉神，屡次献上一样的祭物，这祭物永不能除罪。但基督献了一次永远的赎罪祭，就在神的右边坐下了。主说：“那些日子以后，我与他们所立的约乃是这样：我要将我的律法写在他们心上，又要放在他们的里面。以后就说，我不再纪念他们的罪愆和他们的过犯，这些罪过既赦免，就不用再为罪献祭了。”
Now let me do a very quick comparison for you right now.
让我为大家做一个比较。
In the Old Testament,
在旧约中。
In the Book of Leviticus,
在立位记中。
When the priests begin to offer up sacrifices for the individuals,
当祭司们准备好为个人献祭的时候。
And also on the Day of Atonement,
在赎罪日的时候。
The sin was being covered.
他们的罪被覆盖了。
There's a yearly reminder.
这是一个每年都有的提醒。
Because the blood of animals can never take away sin.
因为动物的血永远不能把罪除去。
The people sin live under condemnation.
人们仍旧生活在定罪中。
They were weary and heavy laden.
他们非常的担忧，担着重担。
They have no rest in God.
他们在神里面没有平安。
But when Jesus came,
但当耶稣来到之后
，the Lamb that took away the sin of the world.
这个无罪的羔羊带走了世界的罪，他是无罪、
he's the
毫无瑕疵的。
Person of the Godhead.
他是三位一体神中的第二位。
He came to fulfill the will of God.
他来是要完成神的旨意。
His blood was sacrificed for us.
他的宝血为我们赎罪。
His blood was shed for us.
他的宝血为我们而洒。
In the Old Testament,
而在旧约中
，sin was covered.
罪被遮盖了。
That's a yearly reminder.
那是每年都要的提醒。
The blood of Jesus Christ.
而耶稣基督的宝血。
The final sacrifice.
这是最终的献祭。
That was shed for us.
为我们而流。
On the cross of Calvary.
在十字架上。
The Bible tells us.
这个圣经告诉我们。
Our sins and lawless deeds, He remembered no more.
神不再纪念我们的罪和。
I say he remembered no more.
他不再纪念。
There's no more condemnation.
不再有定罪。
Why? Because your sin has been completely dealt with.
因为你的罪已经完全被解决了。
You're washed clean by the power of the blood of Jesus Christ.
耶稣基督宝血的大能把你洁净了。
The veil in the temple was ripped open.
区分那个圣殿的那个幔子被完全打开了。
No longer is only the priest can go in.
不再是只有祭司才能进入至圣
所，
因为宝血的大能，
that has washed away all our sin,
洗净了我们所有的罪，
for us,
为我们赎了罪。
He became the substitutionary sacrifice.
他成为替代我们的赎罪祭。
All of us who call the name of Jesus,
我们所有的人都能够呼唤耶稣基督的名。
We are accepted by God.
我们被神所接受。
We are child of the living God.
我们是永生神的孩子。我们被更新了。
We can enter into His presence to behold His face, to seek help and mercy in time of need.
我们可以进入他的面前来接受他的怜悯。
There's therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus.
所以在耶稣基督里再没有定罪。
Revelation chapter 20, chapter 12, verse 10 and 11 says. Revelation chapter 12, verse 10 and 11 says.
启示录十二章十到十一节。
Then I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, "Now salvation and strength in the kingdom of God and the power of His kingdom of Christ has come. For the accuser of the brethren who accuses them before our God day and night has been cast down. And they overcame him, you and I. And they overcame him by their works? No, by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Praise be to God."
Amen.我听见天上有大声音说，我神的救恩能力国度并他基督的权柄现在都来到了，因为那在我们神面前昼夜控告我们弟兄的已经摔下去了，弟兄胜过他是因羔羊的血和自己所见证的道，他们虽至于死也不爱惜性命。
The devil can be condemning you every day.
魔鬼每天可能都在控告我们。
He can be reminding of your past.
他可能每天都在提醒你的过往。
But you tell him.
但是你要告诉他。
It is the blood.
是耶稣基督的宝血。
It is the blood that caused me to be forgiven.
是宝血让我已经被饶恕了。
Jesus, your high priest, is your mediator.
耶稣，你的大祭司是你的中保。
He is your advocate.
他是你的中保。
Whenever the devil accuses you,
不管何时魔鬼控告你的时候
，He said, "No, devil."
他说，魔鬼。
Father, look at my blood.
天父。
My blood has been shed for them.
我的血已经为他们而流。
They have been forgiven.
他们已经被饶恕了。
It has been dealt with.
已经被解决了。
They are accepted into your presence.
在你的面前，他们被接受了。
So let me ask you this question.
所以让我问大家这个问题。
What right have you to enter into the kingdom of God?
当你凭着什么来到神的国度？
Is it because you're a Sunday school teacher? You should be a Sunday school teacher.
是因为你做了这个主日学的老师吗？
Is it because you're a victor who lead worship?
还是说你是敬拜团队带领敬拜吗？
Or is it because of the blood?
还是因为耶稣基督的宝血？
What is the answer?
你的答案是什么？
Come on. The blood of Jesus Christ.
是耶稣基督的宝血。
So the only answer that you can give to God.
所以这是你唯一可以给到神的答案。
I plead the blood. The blood of Jesus cleanses me.
耶稣基督的宝血洁净我。
The blood of Jesus causes me to be accepted, righteous, holy before you.
耶稣基督的宝血让我能在你面前公义的被接受。
Nothing but the blood. Remember when Jesus offered up his blood in the heavenly tabernacle.
又记得耶稣在天上的会幕为我们献上他的宝血的时候。
Being a high priest.
做我们的大祭司的时候，
He sat down at the right hand of the Father.
他坐在神的右手边。
The high priest and the priest had to offer up offering every day.
而大祭司和那些祭司每天都要献祭。
From day to night.
从早到晚。
There's a remembrance of their sin.
来纪念他们的罪。
The blood of Jesus.
而耶稣基督的宝血。
Did it once and for all.
只做了一次，就永远地解决了这个事。
And he sat down.
然后他就坐在神的右手边。
You only sit down when it's finished.
你只有做完了事才坐下，对不对？
In conclusion, let's have the final slide.
然后作为结语，让我们看一下最后这一页。
The Old Testament.
这个旧约。
Is a type and shadow of the cross.
是十字架的这个影子。 预表
at the cross,
而在十字架上
the veil was torn,
这个幔子被撕裂了
in the New Testament,
在新约里面
when you and I are,
当就是你我所在的这个时代
we always look back to the work of the cross,
我们总是回望在十字架上为我们成就的救工
it is the cross,
是十字架
where the blood was shed,
当耶稣的宝血被洒
that we are cleansed,
然后我们被洁净了。
And you remember our sins and lawless deeds no more.
神不再纪念我们的罪。
That is the power of the blood.
这就是宝血的大能。
Let's bow our head and pray.
让我们低头祷告。
With every head bowed and every eyes closed.
当所有人低头祷告的时候。
You might be here today.
你可能今天在这里。
You do not know Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
你还不知道耶稣基督是你
的救主。Some of you might not even know how you are being saved.
有些人可能会想，我们是如何得救的。
It is the best opportunity this morning.
而今天是最好的机会。
To make it clear why are you saved.
来明白为什么我们得救。
Why are you worthy to come before God?
为什么我们配得来到神的面前。
You can only come before God by the blood of the Lamb.
你只有凭着羔羊的宝血才能来到神面前。
The Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, that take away the sin of the world.
是神的羔羊耶稣基督的宝血带走了罪。
The sin that torments you every day.
那每天折磨你的罪。
Can only be washed away by the blood.
只有凭他的宝血才能洁净。
That cause you to stand right before him just like you have never sinned.
能来到，能让你来到神的面前，就像你没有犯过罪一样。
That's why Jesus said.
这是为什么耶稣说。
I am the way.
我是道路。
I am the truth.
我是真理。
I am the life.
我是生命。
If that is you.
如果这是你的话。
You have never received Jesus Christ.
你还没有接受耶稣基督做救主。
Or you are not confident that you are a child of the living God.
或者你还不确信你是神的孩子。
I'd like to lead you in a prayer this morning.
我想要邀请你做这个祷告。
If that is you, just raise up your right hand very quickly and put it down.
如果是你的话，请举起你的右手。
Anyone, just put up your right hand and put it down. Anyone, you're not a Christian, but like to receive Him today, just put up your right hand.
如果你还不是基督徒，你想要。
Put it down. Anyone here?
接受这个救恩，请举起你的右手。
Father, I praise you and thank you for your presence here.
天父，我们感谢赞美你的同在。
Your word has gone forth regarding the power of the blood.
你关于耶稣基督宝血的大能的话已经发出。
I pray that Father, my brothers and sisters will feel secure in your love.
我祷告弟兄姐妹们在你的爱里面能得平安。
There's nothing that we can do to make you love us more.
我们不能做任何事能让你爱我们更多。
There's nothing that we've done, said or spoken to make you love us less.
不管我们说什么做什么也不会让你爱我们更少
you love us unconditionally
你无条件的爱我们
and I pray that Father my brothers and sisters including myself will be so secured in your love
我祷告弟兄姐妹包括我自己我们都在神你的爱里面感到完全安全
we will be confident to enter your presence to be your, hold your face on a daily basis
我们有信心进入你的同在里每天都持守这样的信心
because it is the blood that cleanses us
因为是你的宝血洁净了我们
and now as you leave this place
当我们离开这里
may the love of the Father
愿天父的慈爱
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ
耶稣基督的恩惠
and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit
圣灵的感动与交通
be with you
与你同在
now and forevermore
从今直到永远
Amen
Amen
Well, I hope you enjoyed the service today and thank you so much for joining us. And I know that you've been encouraged by the preaching of the word, that you know that God loves you and he has good thoughts toward you. You can continue to follow us on our website, and our social media accounts in YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram, or simply drop us an email to keep in touch. And here at ICS, we're a church.We're a family that's blessed to bless the community and the nations. So we hope that you were blessed today and you're really starting to think about how you can be a blessing, to your neighbors and those around you. God bless.